Gray hair has made plenty of people in the hair dye industry happy, but for many of us, it's just a sign we're about to get saggy and start complaining about kids these days. What's the deal with gray hair? Why does it happen? Here's what the scientists say. In a twist that not even M. Night Shyamalan would have seen coming, our hair doesn't turn gray at all. According to Harvard Medical School, once a follicle produces hair, the color is set. What does that mean? Essentially, when strands of hair grow in and they're a certain color, that particular piece of hair is always going to be that color. It'll fall out eventually, all hairs do, it's just the natural cycle of things, and when you're young, it'll be replaced by another brown hair. Things start changing as you age.
How come all of a sudden no one wants to talk about my hair turning gray?
The cells responsible for giving your hair its color are called melanocytes, which are the same type of cells that determine our skin color, according to Newsweek. When you shed hair, special stem cells form new melanocytes for your follicles so that when your hair grows back, it has color. Over time, those stem cells stop working and buy a house in Florida or do whatever stem cells do when they retire, and your hair starts to become the before picture in a Just for Men commercial. For most people, their follicles stop producing full color around the age of 35.
You called me an old man.
While we typically end up sporting some gray hair because of the natural aging process, there are things that can make it happen faster, such as stress or illness. Both of those can cause a condition called telogen effluvium, which causes hair to fall out at a much faster than normal rate. When the hair grows back, it's much more likely to come back gray, which gives the appearance of stress-causing premature aging. Graying can also be connected to genetic disorders like tuberous sclerosis. That one causes benign tumors to grow in the heart, brain, lungs, kidneys, eyes, skin, and in addition to premature graying, it's also linked to seizures, learning disabilities, and chronic breathing issues. Then there's also a disorder known as alopecia, which causes you to lose patches of primarily colored hair and can give the appearance of overnight graying. You might be wondering what tells stem cells to produce or not produce melanocytes. Luckily, scientists at the University of Texas Southwestern Medical Center accidentally identified the particular proteins responsible for gray hair while trying to study a rare disease that causes nerve cells to develop tumors. As Time reported in 2017, the researchers were tinkering with the skin cells of mice when they discovered that a protein called CRC20 activates skin cells that turn into a hair shaft. The creation of the hair shaft triggers the production of another protein called stem cell factor, or SCF. When scientists got rid of CRC20, the rodents went bald, and eliminating SCF turned their fur white. So while scientists may not have figured out how to stop your nerve cells from growing horrifying tumors, they at least discovered one huge piece in the puzzle of human aging. So basically, your body is an hourglass that can't be turned over. As time passes, parts of you slip away that you can't get back. That graying hair is basically a sign that another part of your anatomy has stopped working the way it used to. That might sound depressing and a little scary, but it's not the end of the whole world. Just a reminder that the end of you is coming. Sorry. Check out our newest videos right here, plus even more grunge videos about your favorite stuff are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.